yeah.
This is the B episode of today.
Be yourself.
This worthless program comes at you three times, Monday through Friday, and sometimes extra. I'm gonna go home and get some lunch and spend some time with my dog. Man, truly man's best friend. He is a friend of mine, and he's not just a pet. I didn't get much done today so far. Well, I did actually. Trying to get myself down to a better zero base at work so I can work on some other projects. If that makes sense. Without getting too into it, too heavy into it. I have a problem where I pick at my cuticles and like skin around my finger, and I have a really nasty looking, it's embarrassing. It is embarrassing. In a lot of ways, because you know, sometimes they're so glaringly, they're bleeding. My fingertips are literally bleeding. So it's a little embarrassing. You think people are looking at your fingers a lot. God, this light is long. If I don't hit this light right, and I just missed it now, it adds a whole solid minute of having to talk on this show. I need to get gas. No, my gas light is being weird. Like, it pops on and pops off. So I think the last couple times I've been low on gas, I've really, really pushed it to the absolute limit. The gas here is so expensive. But, you know, the other option for gas is, further away, but it's like I don't think time and money for just getting out there. It's not that far away, but it's just a matter of time, really, more than anything. I don't know. It's $3.69. Wow, this is a whole 10 cents cheaper over here. Across the street, there's an Exxon and a Sunoco. The Sunoco is 10 cents cheaper than the Exxon. Huh? What's that all about? Right across the street. You'd think that it wouldn't be that big of a discrepancy. Maybe a couple cents, but 10 cents seems like it's pretty significant. I'm going by the mugs again, as I mentioned earlier today. Let's see if I can. Anybody behind me? No. It's dangerous. Yeah, mugs and some other dishware. Very odd. Some people blowing leaves in the street. Okay, alright, I'm going to draw it here. Appreciate you having to blow your leaves. Not on my time, though. I think for lunch I'm going to have a pita and veggies. Some tomato and onion sandwich. With some parsley? Not fresh parsley. I don't think I have any. No, I don't have any fresh parsley. But, I saw a woman or a man with a 9/11 shirt on. Sometimes I don't know where I'm living. Do you think, like, not that you should, but if you actively wanted to, or if you ever thought, really, just that you lived in a place where you wouldn't see someone wearing a shirt like that. I just saw total evidence that you are never in that place doesn't exist. You are always in a potentially you are always going to see an obese, ambiguously sexed human, ambiguous gendered individual with a gaudy 9/11 freedom shirt on their body. Doesn't matter where you live. There's some, I've lived in some bad neighborhoods. The neighborhood I live in now is okay, you know, but the like surrounding neighborhoods are a mix of, you know, very very wealthy and then just very suburbia. And the shadows of some mansions for sure. Which is like, you know, fine. It's definitely, I don't know, sparks an envious feeling in me in a lot of times, to be quite honest. Sorry, my throat. This is, I might have to wrap it up earlier today. I don't know if I can, how many more of these I can do. Yeah, I don't know. I seem to always wind up in areas like that, but it doesn't matter. Like, this is a real liberal town. I think in a lot of ways, there's a Democrat, control of local government. Not that that means anything. I got a neighbor, not really a neighbor, but there's a house about a 5-minute walk, 10-minute walk from me that I go by sometimes, and it's, you know, it's really the super, super liberal jerk house, I call it. That was the first time I called it that. But they have, kind of very, you know, Occupy Wall Street signs in their window and on their lawn. Like, we are the 99%, all over their front door. Like I'm not even kidding you. Like, a big poster, like, taped to the front door of the house. And then they have signs in all the windows, like, end torture and all sorts of, other, you know, Occupy Wall Street, like, slogans. And meanwhile, there's just a, oh my god, what is that? There's just, like, 3 exploded trash bags in the road here. Oh, wow. Did they fall out of the trash? And then I see 3 cars ahead of me. There's a garbage truck. I wonder if they just fell out. You'd think they would stop. You know. Bottom line here is, look, it's warm today. You stay positive, people. You know, do what you gotta do. I'm gonna go walk my dog and eat a pita and hummus sandwich. Some mayo and I think some mustard. Right now we've got, my household has, we've got 3 open brown mustards with just a little bit of mustard in each. We're those kind of people. It's kind of, hilarious, really. You always just, you know, 3 going at once. Does that happen to other people? Can other people do it? Is it just me and my wife? Do we have a deficiency in terms of the game of mustard usage and optimization of bottled mustard, brown mustard usage? Yep.